Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We are coming out of a series presentation that was exclusive, a series that presented 7 segments, and hoping those that enjoyed the over-reasoning mind and listened to each and every presentation that was presented inside that series, which was season 1, you were equipped by the word of God. And today we want to enter into a dimension of a sermon presentation which the Holy Spirit gave me 72 hours ago. And I was in the middle of completing a season which was completed 24 hours ago. And I'm praying that the message that I was given 72 hours ago remains valid in the spirit, and praying that the Holy Spirit is going to usher me to present this presentation without any interference of demonic spirits, without any interference of the devil, without any interference that causes any interruptions to the information signals that are linked to your spiritual minds. And today, I want to take you into a deep exposure in the spirit, and I want to present the devil's revelations. The devil's revelations. And I'm praying that the Holy Spirit will give you understanding in this presentation. So for us to understand more on this presentation, let us get into scriptures. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 1, and it reads, "It is not expedient for me doubtless to glory. I will come to the visions and the revelations of the Lord." The scripture begins by saying, "It is not expedient for me doubtless to glory." Meaning that there is an area that is being defined by the narrative writer in the spirit, which might not be necessary, which might not be expedient, which might not be that important for him to value when it comes to glorying about himself. And then he switches lanes in the spirit while he's in the middle of explaining this issue, and then says, "I'll come to visions and revelations of the Lord." And then after having said, "I'll come to visions and revelations of the Lord," he then says, "I knew a man in Christ above 14 years ago." Now, I need you to understand something. He says, "I knew a man in Christ 14 years ago." And when he says 14 years ago, he does not mean the current man. He says 14 years ago. Now, and then he says, "Whether in the body I cannot tell, or whether out of the body I cannot tell, but God knoweth." Now, when the scripture has been written by one that is a chiefest apostle and says, "Whether in the body I cannot tell, and out of the body I cannot tell," it is left for me as the revelator to reveal the mystery that is hidden behind the information that was written without certainty. The information that was written without any certainty is information that leaves you with the certain probabilities. And the probabilities that have been left inside this information that left the writer uncertain is clearly and evidently written. In the sense that we are not given information whether this man from 14 years ago was operating in the body or operating in the spirit. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. And then says, are you a man in Christ about 14 years ago? Whether in the body, I cannot tell, or whether out of the body, I cannot tell again, but God knows. And this thing that is only known by God is what I'm going to reveal. As long as this thing is only known by God, I'm going to know it by revelation. Such a man was caught up to the third heaven. This man that was caught up to the third heaven, we cannot tell whether he was caught up there in the body or in the spirit. And I knew such a man again, whether in the body or out of the body, and again I cannot tell. Never in the scripture have I read anything that is written by Apostle Paul which ends by saying I cannot tell, meaning that anything that an apostle is written and is writing saying I cannot tell, he is honestly being inspired by his mind to confess the truth. He has seen that it is better for me to write that I cannot tell than for him to write a lie. He did not choose to write what he believed that he knew, yet it was not certain. So he chose to write that I cannot tell. Why? Because he knew that he was not fully aware of that information. And the mystery that is continually being explained here is of a man that was caught up in the heaven. Whether in the body, he could not tell. Whether out of the body, again, he could not tell. And he knew the man, whether in the body or out of the body, again, he could not tell. But again, the scripture ends saying, only God knoweth. Now, let's hear the description of this man. How that he was caught up into paradise and heard unspeakable words, which it is not lawful for a man to utter. Remember, in the narration, the writer is saying whether in the body I cannot tell or out of the body. So it is left for me as the revelator to decide whether it was in the body or out of the body. Because if we leave that information hanging like that, it's going to confuse many. And then he then chooses to say he was caught up into paradise and heard unspeakable words, which it was not lawful for men to utter. Meaning that there are things that were spoken by this man at a certain level, which were out of this world, which were not allowed to be uttered by a certain man. And this man remains a mystery whether he was in the body or out of the body. We are soon going to touch on that area. Of such a man and one will I glory, yet of myself I will not glory, but in my own infirmities. Of such a man who spoke unspeakable words, revelations that are hidden, I will glory, but of myself I will not glory. And when he says of myself, which man is he talking about? He's talking about a man who would rather leave the information hanging without knowing the truth that was behind, without knowing the conviction that was behind the message. The same man that said, I cannot tell, is the man that he is now referring unto. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying here. There is a man that gave us information, and of that man, he would not choose to glory about. Why? Because that man is limited, and that man, at the same time, he could not tell whether that man was operating in the spirit or in the physical. He could not tell. He would not choose to glory about that kind of man. But you would choose to glory about a man that spoke unspeakable things. But again, having chosen to glory about a man that chose to speak unspeakable things, here's another man that he does not want to glory about. Why? Because he could not tell whether that man was operating inside the body or out of the body. He could not tell. I hope someone is understanding what the Spirit of God is saying here. For though I would desire to glory, I shall not be a fool. Why? Because there is information that pertains a man that still remains a mystery. A man that operated in the spirit or out of the spirit. A man that operated either in the body or out of the body. A man that he could not tell how he operated. We're soon going to find out what kind of a man was this and how was this man operating. For though I would desire to glory, I shall not be a fool, for I will say the truth to myself. But now I forbear, lest any man should think of me above that which he sees me to be, or that he hears of me. I'm going to repeat this part, because this very part is the part which is the key to the whole presentation. He says, I would desire to glory, but I shall not be a fool. Why? Because in the eyes of many that see me giving out revelations. Are you understanding? In the eyes of many that see me giving revelations and giving revelations, they would choose to applaud me. They would choose to praise me. But lest any man should think of me above that which he sees me to be, or hears about me. Meaning that he is trying to warn people not to see him above the level which they see him to be. He is warning men not to uplift him above the level which they see him operating. Meaning that because of this mystery man that has got certain faults, he is trying to restrict people to see him above the level which they see him to be. Yet he knows that this man has got afflictions. Not just afflictions. This man is not approved. This man is not confirmed where he actually operates. Whether he's operating in the body or operating in the spirit, it cannot be told. In terms of the validity of even the information that he dispatches, it means there is a need to even to find out who really is this man that is operating, dispatching the information of unspeakable words. Who really is this man? Is he a man that is operating in the spirit, or a man that is operating in the flesh? But the answer that you are given is, I cannot tell. And we are still investigating who really this man is. And lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of revelations. And lest I should be exalted by who? By the people. Above measure. Meaning that he is saying, though I'm operating at this measure of revelations. Do not take me to that measure of revelations. Why? Because I told you about a man from 14 years ago who is a mystery man, who is operating also in the dimension of revelations. But the things that he was doing, it left me with many questions of whether he was operating inside the boat or outside the boat. Meaning that there were weaknesses, there were faults about that man. Though he had moments that he was speaking unspeakable revelations, though he had moments that he was operating in the third heaven, I don't want that man to be uplifted above measure through the abundance of revelations that he had. Why? Because he has got moments that you cannot tell whether he's operating inside the body or out of the body. And that man, and then he says, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, to perfect me, lest I should be exalted above measure. Child of God, I want to reveal about a man that was not operating out of the body, yet he spoke unspeakable things. I want to reveal about the man that was the revealing, yet it is the same man that was afflicted. I want to reveal about the man to whom Satan sent the messenger to perfect. Yet the scripture says, and the Lord sent Satan as a messenger to afflict. There is a man that was operating in the spirit, but was not operating in the spirit. He was operating from inside the body. And there is a man that was caught up in the third heaven. And that man truly operated in the dimension of heaven. But there is a man that Apostle Paul did not choose to glory about. And that man was not operating in the third heaven. That man was caught up inside the body. And that man was releasing revelations, not from heaven. There's a man from 14 years ago. He is not named. He spoke unspeakable things, caught up in the third heaven, and he could not tell whether he was operating inside the body or out of the body. Why? Because he had moments that he would operate inside the body, and he had moments that he would operate inside the body. I want to talk about the devil's revelations. There are moments that the spirit man was operating inside the body. There are moments that the spirit man was operating outside the body. But here, there is no significance of the spirit. It's describing a man who had infirmities, but while he's still revealing. And this man was not operating inside the body, but also outside the body. And that man had moments where he was revealing things, not from the third heaven, but things in the carnal dimension. This is why he says, whether out of the body, I cannot tell, or inside the body, I cannot tell. But one thing that he knew is that his spirit at moments that it would get caught up in the third heaven. This is why at the beginning of the scripture it says, it is not expedient for me doubtless to glory. I'll come to visions and revelations of the Lord. So what gives us assurance that there were only visions and revelations from the Lord? When there is a man whom he can't tell whether he operated inside the body or out of the body. This information that does not pertain only weaknesses. This information that does not only pertain afflictions. This information also pertains the operations of this man, whom he can't tell whether he was operating in the physical or in the spirit. This information does not pertain the man that was in the third heaven. This information leaves many probabilities about the man whom he can't tell whether he was operating in the physical or in the spirit. Meaning that there was a man who was operating as a reflection of a man in the third heaven. But that man was not operating in the spirit. He was operating in the flesh. And still that man that was operating in the flesh, he was still giving revelations. I'm talking about the revelations that were not coming from the third heaven. And I'm talking about the devil's revelations. And he says, lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of revelations. Meaning that there is a level that he did not want to be exalted above measure through the abundance of revelations which are not coming from God. Because there was no way that he could be exalted above measure through revelations that are coming from God. He would remain humble. He would remain in humility. Meaning that there is being exalted above measure and you get lifted up above the capacity, above the audacity, above the measure that you have been given by God to reveal, and you start revealing things that are beyond the man that operates in the third heaven, and you start revealing things that are not coming from heaven. I'm talking about a level where a man that reveals can be hijacked by the devil. Recently in a deliverance session, and it was not the first time, where Lucifer is threatening that he can restart mysteries and revelations and hijack a disciple and give that disciple power to run the ministry under darkness. It was a threat. But that threat, it was not the first time hearing that threat. On 31 December, on the chaotic night, there was a manifestation of a spirit. And that manifestation of the spirit, it came out saying, I am mysteries and revelations. And it did confess that I'm not in control of you, revelator. But I can hijack this ministry. What it means is that there is a difference between the ministry and the revelator. But the reason why that spirit could not be able to hijack the ministry right now is because the revelator who operates in the third heaven is still functioning. Meaning that this spirit is looking for a way to distance all the disciples from the revelator, and it can restart mysteries and revelations that operates not in the third heaven dimension, but operates in this world. And they continue with the revelations that are not coming from God. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. I'm talking about the devil's revelations. Apostle Paul writes in scripture, a man that was filled with all knowledge, wisdom in the word, says, I cannot tell whether the man was in the body or out of the body. Well, there can be a ministry that operates in the body. As long as the one that is leading that ministry is also inside the body. And there can be a ministry that operates outside the body, and a ministry that operates in revelations out of the body. It does not function on the pulpit. It functions in the realms. You can become the revelator, a fake revelator that does not take people into the dimensions, a revelator that is not anointed by heaven, a revelator that does not have the backup of John the Revelator, a revelator that does not have the backup of Jesus, and you function leading mysteries and revelations not under the body of Christ, not under the church of Jesus Christ, but under darkness. Like the man whom Apostle Paul cannot tell whether he was operating in the body or out of the body. For this thing I besought the Lord thrice, that it might depart from me. But it could not. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Here the scripture is now talking about infirmities, afflictions that come with the ministry work. But there can be weaknesses that a man is allowed to enter ministry with, and he fails to deal with those weaknesses to the level that the devil finds you as a perfect custodian of darkness. Not because you are not called, no. You are called, but you have got weaknesses. Jesus says, behold, cometh Lucifer, and he has nothing of his in me. And there is a level when Lucifer can find something of his in you. And you do a joint venture with Satan in ministry. A joint venture that leads to destruction. In a moment, Jesus asked his disciples, who do the people say I am? And Peter just came out and said, you are Christ, the Son of the living God. In just a moment, out of the same Peter in whom Christ said, heaven has revealed this, flesh and blood has not said such. In just a moment, the Lord was rebuking a devil who was operating inside that Peter. In just a moment, in the same Peter who he had revealed, in just a moment, the Lord was now rebuking. There's a man that was operating inside the body, and there's a man that was operating out of the body. And the reason why Apostle Paul says I cannot tell is because he was an apostle, he was not the revelator. There's a level where you need the revelator, which is in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 30. If anything be revealed to another that sits by, let it be first hold peace. And who are these who can get a temporary revelation then they are not revelators? For you may all prophesy one by one. This is why the whole nation has got prophets. You are all allowed, and I'm announcing this to you, you are all allowed to prophesy one by one, that you may learn. For the spirits of the prophets are subject unto the prophets. But if a thing is revealed to another that is sitting by, let the first hold his peace. Let that very first reveal to hold his peace. Why? Because he's not the revelator. He needs to hear from the revelator. For God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of saints. Child of God, there is a level where the devil can come with his own revelations. Revelations that are mixed and mingled with the ideologies of men that operate inside the body. And the man that operates out of the body does not function. Where the devil paralyzes the man that operates outside the body and interacts with the man who is the body. And the man that is the body joins ministry and starts revealing things of this world, not things of heaven. Revealing in this world, not revealing from the dimensions. And what you get there is titled the devil's revelations, and the ministry operates under Satan. Not only the ministry operating under Satan, and souls are hijacked. I'm praying for this ministry of mysteries and revelations to function in the Lord, to function in the mantle of the Lord. And I rebuke the lying spirits. I rebuke the spirit of revelation from the devil in the name of Jesus.